Welcome to Life Happened, the place where people send in their very personal life stories for us to share with you. You can make a huge difference in their lives by sharing your feelings and advice for them in the comments below. My name is Emma, your host, and this story is from David. Dear Emma, I was never the kind of person to experiment with drugs. Sure, I've tried marijuana a few times and I've drank and smoked, but something always told me to avoid illegal substances. One of the reasons being is that they completely ruined someone who was once a great friend of mine. A few years ago, I met a group of friends after going through a rough time with financial, familial, and education-related issues. The lot of us did everything with one another. Video games, drinking, talking politics, etc. There was one person in the group that spent more time with me than anyone. His name was Jamie. Note, it's great to feel like a part of like-minded people. Jamie was a smaller guy with an effeminate sounding voice. Whenever I was around, he always seemed to be the first person to hang out with me. He was nerdy and silly, but he was still a good friend. He was the kind of friend that you could banter with and no one would get angry with one another. He liked to smoke marijuana. Nobody in our circle was particularly bothered by that. We just politely asked him not to come to the hangouts if he was under the influence. He agreed to that notion, at first. Note, sounds like a good friendship, but something tells me this friendship is headed for difficult times. A year passed and Jamie had met some of my oldest, closest friends. Strangely, he started to speak poorly of them and some of the others within our friends group. He accused a good friend of mine, Austin, of avoiding us and refusing to be around us. He called him lazy, worthless, etc. The problem was that Austin was working a full-time job and putting himself through college. I explained that to Jamie, but he just wouldn't listen. He was insistent that Austin had wronged us. I was ignorant to his change of personality, so I stopped spending time with Austin. Note, true friends wouldn't have done this. Perhaps Jamie was jealous of your friendship with Austin. Jamie and I got into more and more fights. I would ask him simple questions along the lines of, "Did you take the trash out?" Only to have him explode on me, yelling at me about something that had nothing to do with anything going on. I wondered for a long time what had made him so unstable. I realized that he started to take our banter far too seriously. Realizing that he was genuinely upset, I made the mistake of avoiding him for a few months. The friends group and I collectively agreed that he needed to get his problems sorted out. He didn't. He only got worse. Jamie knew I was going through a breakup, so he spent a good amount of time with me doing his best to cheer me up by playing games, drinking, etc. But it just wasn't the same. He wasn't the same guy that I met with a fun-loving, happy-go-lucky outlook on life. Jamie was bitter and resentful about things, and he felt that everyone was out to get him. When I took up with a significant other, he grew even worse. He began flirting with my girlfriend and inviting her out to drinks. I spoke up once and told him to calm down. He cursed me out for being a wet blanket. It was then I realized that Jamie had no sense of self-control from the crippling amounts of illicit substances he was ingesting. Note, sounds as though Jamie was terribly addicted to drugs and couldn't be a true friend anymore. The effects of drugs can be terrible on oneself. Another year or so passed, and Jamie started awkwardly showing up to meet us completely drunk and or high. I confronted him about his substance abuse and he laughed. He began accusing me of being a terrible friend for not being there for him when he needed it most. On top of that, he confessed to me that he was experimenting with drugs other than marijuana. In truth, that scared me. I made a poor effort of trying to console him, but it was all in vain. Jamie vanished, completely gone like the wind for 2 whole weeks. I and the others made our best efforts to call and make contact with him to make sure he was okay. I had trouble sleeping, thinking that he had overdosed or worse. Note, illicit drugs can certainly have a profound and negative impact on a person's life, clouding their judgment and other faculties. This reminds me of a book on this subject, which we have listed in the description box below. And now is a good time to hit the like button. Jamie reappeared after those 2 weeks, and my friends told me that he bragged about all the cocaine, crack, and speed that he had taken. They were scared of what he'd become. They express concern to Jamie about his addictions, only to be slapped in the face with accusations of us being horrible friends and how we were never there for him when he needed us most. I confronted him again. I expressed my own concern to be met with the same response. Come on, you won't even let me talk about the great few weeks I've just had. I explained to him that he worried us all nearly to death because of his selfish choices. After arguing and yelling at each other for what seemed to be hours, we were seemingly getting nowhere. He was always stubborn, even before his substance abuse. I had to make an ultimatum. You choose between your friends and drugs, right here, right now. I don't know why I was so hurt when he subtly chose the drugs. He even suggested that because we didn't do such drugs with him, that we were not his friends. Note, sounds like Jamie has needed rehab for a long time. I was bitter about the whole situation for a long time. Admittedly, I still am. I lost a very good friend of mine to substance abuse. He didn't overdose, no. He simply chose to stick with his addictions instead of his friends. It's been nearly 3 years since we all stopped talking to him. According to a few people, he actually decided to clean himself up. He wanted to apologize to me. Should I let him back into my life after all that's been said and done? Did I not do enough to help Jamie when he was struggling? Why do I sometimes feel that my neglect led to his substance abuse? David, thank you for your story. I will now offer my thoughts and opinions as to David's letter. First, I believe it was imperative that Jamie had entered rehab, visited a psychologist and/or psychiatrist a very long time ago. Jamie is a troubled soul to begin with, and the illicit drugs he took only made his personality worse, since people are not themselves when they're so drugged out. These drugs impair judgment, attitude, cause great harm to people's bodies and minds, including death. Rehab and other professional help is what Jamie so desperately needed. Second, no, it is not David's fault that Jamie reduced himself to being a drug addict. That was solely Jamie's decision. We're not talking about children here, rather adults. Jamie exhibited a coarse personality before he ever began using hard drugs. He was hard on David regarding David's friendship with Austin. As I mentioned, Jamie is someone who has issues, and perhaps they stem from his upbringing, poor societal choices. We can only imagine. Third, now, should David see Jamie again after 3 years of having no contact? I would say only if Jamie is clean and free of all the hard drugs. I don't believe it would be a good idea if Jamie was still addicted, because with friends like Jamie under the influence, who needs enemies? And no, I am not at all saying one should abandon their friends who take illicit drugs, harming themselves every step of the way, but one must know his or her limits. If David maintains his vigilant attitude regarding drug use, then why shouldn't David see his friend again? Who knows? Perhaps Jamie is drug-free and is leading a, quote, normal life. I just hope that Jamie is clean for Jamie's sake and his friendships. We wish David the very best. And today's quotes are, quote, "There's not a drug on earth that can make life meaningful," unquote, by Sarah Kane. And the next one is, quote, "Addiction begins with the hope that something, quote, out there can instantly fill up the emptiness inside," unquote, by Jean Kilborn. So perhaps you may have a comment, opinion, question, or answer to David's story. If so, we would like to hear from you. And you can read other people's comments and opinions below relating to this letter. And remember that by liking and subscribing to Life Happened, you will hear me read letters every week on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, which people send us about issues they are dealing with in their lives. These are real-life personal stories and people's everyday experiences. And don't forget, if you have a personal story or issue which you would like to share with us, please send us an email using the email provided in the description box below. We would be very happy to hear from you. We thank you for joining us here today, where life happened. See you next time, and have a wonderful day.